Okay, guys, let's do this. We're looking at USD ZAR. So the question is, guys, will ZAR hit 20 rand against one US dollar? So technically, it looks like that, guys, but we just have to break it down, try to analyze it on technically, just to see if ZAR can hit 20 rand, which I'm convinced is going to hit looking at technical analysis. So let's start from here, guys. Looking at this level here, it was around 2011. So from 2011, ZAR was on 6 rand 50. It was on 6 rand 50. From there, it's been going up ever since. As you can see, it's been going up, and then it hit what? It hit 17 rand in 2016. So 5 years later, ZAR from 6 rand to hit, it hit 17 rand 60. Can you imagine that? Can you believe that? So let's try to analyze it on technical analysis to see whether it's going to hit 20 rand the coming years. I don't know how many years it's going to take to hit that 20 rand, but looks like technically it's going to hit the 20 rand. So from there, from 17 rand, it went down and went up. And from here, I think it was around 18 rand, 11 rand. Yes, it's from 11 rand. And around 2019 here, somewhere here, it's when I made the analysis that, okay, ZAR will hit what? Will hit 17 rand 60 again. So if we can just show you quickly how I did it, how I analyzed it, like, it was very simple, guys. First, it was this change of structure. It was very simple. And another thing, it was this bullish flag here, right? Or bullish pennant, whatever you want to call it. So one price reach this trend line here, it went down. When it hit this trend line, anticipated that, okay, from here it's gonna do what? It's gonna go up to this level to hit 17 rand again. So this year around March, right, it hit 17 rand 50 again, and then it passed that 17 rand 50 towards what price is that? It passed that 17 rand 50 to create a new high there. So These two lines here are the previous highs, looking at weekly time frame. So the question is, will ZAR hit 20 rand or the coming years or even this year? We don't know. But the answer is here, guys. The answer is based on the technical analysis. So the biggest question now is, what is the price doing? What is price doing now, right? If you're looking at this, guys, we can see that, okay, first of all, like I always do, I try to identify my supply and demand, right? So this is my demand zone. So I saw a pure breakout, guys. This thing here is a pure breakout, just pure breakout. So after every breakout, price should go back to test. So as you can see, price went back. It's going back to test that level there before it's gonna go all the way up. So like I said, if using the ABCD strategy, if this level here is your A, quickly, if this level here is your A, bear with me, guys. If this is your A, your B, and then this level here, we are looking at C, and then number D, guys, is not going to respect this level. You know, number D is going to break this level to go all the way up. And if you can check this level, we are around 20 rand. So ZAR might hit 20 rand, like, guys, looking at higher time frame. So if you are an investor, if you are everything, just have to buy ZAR against anything, against this. Buy USD against ZAR, and then you make money on that. Buy it until it hit 20 rand. So let's try to break it down quickly on lower time frames. So let's go to daily. What do we see on daily? Remember, on weekly, we saw this before we go on. What we saw? We saw a breakout, which we call it change of structure. And then it formed like the order block there. And then we can use the FIBO, right? If you pull your FIBO from that to that level there, it looks like using the FIBO, it looks like it hit a golden zone already. So it's ready for it to go all the way up to 20. So I'm expecting this move here, A, B, right? And then we have C, right? And then we have A, B, C, D. And then I'm expecting this move, this impulse, we have it here to move the very same level going all the way up to that level there. So let's quickly go to lower time frame. Let's take daily quickly. What do you see on daily? Right. Okay. Let's see on daily. I think I'm running on network. We're on daily. Cool. Good. So we are quickly on daily now, guys, as you can see. So let's see what we have on daily. So on daily, as you can see, we still have that demand zone there. Right. This is our demand zone there. We still have the trend line there. So looking at daily, we just have to draw the trend lines quickly. Right. There we go. It looks like it's forming like a bullish pennant, right? It's forming a bullish pennant. So remember, for you to identify that the bullish pennant is about to break, it has to squeeze a little bit in into that triangle, right? It has to squeeze a little bit in inside the triangle. So you might see it doing like this before it breaks down. So, but the whether it's moving up or down is going to be determined by what? By the breakout of this high here, and they came back to test, and then from there it's going back to 19 rand. So 19 rand for me is going to be our first exit, and then the 20 rand is going to be our last exit based on the ABCD strategy. So for you to determine that now ZAR is about to go, we just have to wait for the breakout here, the retest, and then we complete it going to this level here, which is 19 rand, for us to take our first take profit. And then on 20 rand, we're taking our second take profit. The reason I'm saying we take the second take profit at 20 rand is that price is not going to respect this level here, right? When price is doing the ABCD, it's not respecting the first level, it's respecting the other level. So this level here will be useless. So price will just break it going all the way up. But here is going to be our first take profit, our second take profit at 20 rand. So let's quickly go to lower time frame H4 to see what we can get. Okay, if we go to H4. Okay, let's see what we can get on H4. So looking at H4 again, guys, let me just try to zoom it and just make it easy for you guys. Okay, yeah, we still have the breakout on H4, as you can see here, which I think is going to be very much clear on H1. So on H4, it forms a symmetrical triangle. As you can see there, guys, it's a symmetrical triangle, which is the pole. The pole of this triangle is from here to there, right? And then the breakout of the triangle, it breaks out of the triangle here, right? Breaks out of the triangle, went back to test, right? We might buy it here going back to 17 rand, right? From there to test this, and then went back to straight to 19 rand, right? So it's very, very easy, guys. We just have to find, play around with it to find it where we can get the entry. So let's go to the overall of the market, guys. Besides going back to 20 rand, guys. Don't confuse it. So let's go to lower time frame, H1. Let's see what we can get on H1. Okay. Let me just get rid of everything, wait for H1. There we go. They're on H1. Let me see what you have on H1. Right. Okay. Well, H1 looks very, very interesting. So, like I said, the level that we're looking at now will be this one. On H4, for those who trade short term trades, we are on H4, and then this is the level, the other level that we have there, right? So as you can see, do we have any change of structure? Yes, we do. Right, we've got a trend line there, which confirmed that the price was going up, because price has been bouncing there for several times, as you can see. It's been bounced here, bounced there, and then now it's here. So we are looking at the move going all the way up to that level. So do we have change of structure? I think we do, yes. We do have change of structure, because we can join this trend line. Before you draw a trend line, guys, you just have to have bounces. Like, this is my first bounce, second bounce, third bounce, fourth bounce. There we go. Or you can just draw it like that. It's still fine. And then it breaks out, now came back to test. So yeah. So yeah, it breaks down, breaks out, came back to test. So I'm expecting it to break out to this level to hit 17 rand 20. From there, came back to test this level, and then it's gonna hit around 19 rand or 20 rand up there. So guys, just be careful with it. If you're jumping in now, go in. If you're leaving it until it reach that demand zone on daily, just wait for it. But for me, guys, enjoy your trading, guys. From me, Bruce Lewis and Super Forex. See you guys next week.